All right, let's go with that. Be careful. Don't hit the button.
I have just a little kick. Yeah, but I heard some, going back from the last video, what was talking about the Catholic Church, how you said the Catholic, there was a monk that went to Rome or something and trying to incorporate some Buddhists. But I've heard some Catholic theologians, they explain away why, you know, they, if you ask the Catholics, why do you have all this pagan symbolism in the church? Why do you celebrate pagan holy days? You know what they'll tell you? They'll tell you, well, at the end of the day, all these pagan spiritual beliefs all go back to the Most High. And the Most High used all these different belief systems to push forth his spiritual truths.
You know,
they try to explain and try to justify.
Yeah, that's what they do.
They love to twist shit, you know? They love to twist it. Well, the Lord clearly says in the scriptures, learn not the ways of the heathen. He didn't say, take all the spiritual truths that you find in Buddhism, you know, and incorporate them into your beliefs.
Take it all.
The Lord did not say that. He said, learn not the ways of the heathen.
That's right.
Crystal clear, cut and dry.
If anybody know where it is, the Fables scripture, anybody know where it is?
Sound like Timothy.
Fables, that's in Timothy. We was reading that
last
week.
Yeah, sure it's Timothy, ain't it?
Yeah.
It's one in Hebrews that says,
Timothy, first chapter.
One in Hebrews said, don't be as children carried away by multiple doctrines or something like that.
Yeah, multiple. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, that's
or diverse doctrines.
I mean, that should be common sense.
Because a child.
There we go with common. There's no such thing as common.
Titus. That's the one I was looking for.
Oh, yeah, it's in Timothy and Titus.
Yeah.
It's in both of them.
Because a fucking child believes in Santa Claus, a tooth fairy. And the fucking the honey bunny, whatever the fuck. That's what these motherfuckers do.
You talk to my son. What do they think about?
Oh yeah. This son's he sounds smart. Hey, you know what I'm saying?
They go hard.
Yeah.
I done created two missiles of truth to shoot at this wicked ass inside.
Two mass destruction.
That's the spirit of the Lord to let you know, allow me to have two children like that. You know, two sons. Be able to have the opportunity to raise them up properly, the right way.
Shit.
No, I mean, really, I think about it. I have two sons. I get to teach them things I never got to learn when I was young. I got to teach them, you know, Hebrew. I don't give them too much. I don't try to overload their young minds. I give them a little bit at a time because they're young. You know what I mean? But I be teaching them. I teach them.
Hey, how you feel about your America right now, man?
It's like a spy out of an old 50s movie from the Cold War.
One of these devils teaching the falsehood at these universities, probably.
But anyway, you know, I mean, just think of one of us growing up, if we got to learn etymologies, Latin, you know, a little Hebrew.
Shit, man, that's weird.
We'd be.
I grew up retarded.
Me too, I grew up super retarded. Dumb, just retarded.
For real.
Perfect word is retarded.
Not been taught nothing, man.
My learning didn't start till I was about 29, 30.
You know?
Is when I stumbled across the brothers at Great Millstone.
Right.
I never even heard the word etymology in my life before I watched a Great Millstone video. I gotta give them, through the spirit of the Lord, I gotta give them all the credit.
That's right.
Seriously.
That's why he appointed us elders.
I didn't know what the hell. I never in my life thought I'd be able to read Hebrew, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Never.
Yes,
it was through the Spirit of the Lord, you know, he gave us his knowledge.
That's right. Titus 1, and I'm going to start at 12. One of themselves, even a prophet of their own, said, the Cretans are always liars, beasts, slow bellies.
Yeah. That we looked that up before. Hey, get on the Wikipedia and look up the book of Titus. Man, there was some, he was quoting he was quoting a Cretan right there. I forget his name, man. Yeah, go ahead, my fault.
Okay.
Look it up on Wikipedia, though, and there's a good article on the book of Titus, and you'll see what I'm talking about.
Okay, this witness is true, wherefore rebuke them sharply that they may be sound in the faith. Not giving heed to Jewish fables and commandments of men that turn from the truth.
Commandments of men. What's a commandment of men? A commandment of man is you gotta celebrate Christmas. You gotta celebrate Easter. What's another commandment of men? You gotta do a bunch of dumb shit on Sunday. You gotta go to church. You gotta stand up when it's time to pray. Even though the Bible says don't stand and pray in the synagogues, but you can do it anyway. You know, because your preacher said to do it.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
He's the authority figure.
He's the authority.
Yeah, yeah.
What's the other one? Oh, the Catholic Church have a commandment where the priests have to shave their beards.
Gay?
No. Gay. No, that is faggot shit is a more proper term.
Faggot. Just a motherfucker. No mustache, no beard, no nothing.
That's a commandment of man. Yeah. Telling, because the Bible, in the book of Leviticus, you're not supposed to shave your beard. But you cannot be a Catholic priest with a beard. I mean, I give credit to the Orthodox preachers. They all have beards. Even though they still going off too, though. Because they still incorporate a lot of the paganism into their beliefs.
That's right.
Which is off. Oh yeah, the Catholic priests are not allowed to have wives.
Hey, we put curses on these buses and shit, man.
Yeah,
driver. A bus driver got pistol whipped the other day, man.
Oh, did he?
Yep. Got pistol whipped.
That's what he gets.
And them bus a woman got robbed.
The bus drivers are dicks.
Yeah, yeah.
They'll leave your ass at the bus stop and laugh at you. Just so they can stay on time.
And you got to get somewhere too. And they got the money. That's fucked up.
That is fucked up.
That's fucked up.
And the bus costs $2.
$2.
Why does the bus cost so goddamn? You think you're going to save money on gas by riding the bus? Nope. $2.
That's a heavy tax.
$2 fucking?
That's a heavy
tax. You got
tax.
All these motherfuckers riding the same goddamn bus and it costs $2 a person. Really?
That's fucked up. A heavy tax on the people.
It costs really the same amount for a bus pass as it does for a month's worth of gas.
It does. Exactly the same. You ain't saving shit. They going to make sure you do not say shit. Let's get back to the topic, though.
That's fucked up.
Back to the Catholic Church. Read that scripture again.
Which one?
That what you, the one
14.
You just,
not giving heed to Jewish fables and commandments of men that turn from the truth.
Commandments meant back to the Catholic Church. I'm not just ratting out Catholics. But you got to. Because where in the Bible did it say if you're a preacher or a priest or whatever, a deacon, what else you want, a bishop, where does it say that you're not allowed to have a wife? It doesn't say that. It actually teaches you how to deal with your wives.
Yes, sir.
Because Peter was the head of the church. Peter had a wife. You know what I'm saying?
Ain't he the first pope? Nah.
That's faggot shit, man. That's some old faggot shit, straight up. There's no other way to explain it.
Think they Jedi and shit.
Faggot. Oh, yeah, some Jedi shit. Right, exactly. We was talking about that earlier. How in the Jedi, they push that same vibration in Star Wars.
Jedi's in the scriptures. Jediah.
Oh, there you go. It's just all based on the Bible one way or another.
On the dark side for some pussy.
Dark side was actually the light side.
I'm going to see that shit, figure that out. I can't wait to go see that,
though. Really, that's fake.
Brothers are saying that's some spiritual shit to go see.
They're coming out Independence,
too. You
know
I got to watch it just because.
Yeah, that's coming out in summer.
Yeah.
The dude's name, the new
and
guy.
X-Men.
Ryo Ken or something, or Ken Ra. The new Sith Lord.
I have no
Ryo Ken. The new, he's supposed to be like the new Darth Vader.
Yeah, I know he looks different. And I saw the commercial when he was caressing the face of the old one.
He was all fucked up.
Darth Vader.
Because Anakin was the best character of all the Star Wars.
Hell yeah.
Because he quoted a scripture in the Bible. And he said, you're either with me or you're against me. It was in, what's the name of that movie? In Revenge of the Sith, he got in a battle with Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Yeah.
And he told Obi-Wan Kenobi, he's like, look, you're either with me or you're against me. And Obi-Wan said, that's only something a Sith Lord would say from the dark side.
That's blasphemy right there.
But
that's
blasphemy. Exactly, blasphemy. That's the Lord, the one they call Jesus. He said, you're either with me or against me.
Nigga, I wish he could have won. That shit was fun. I used to love Star Wars, man.
And then, Obi-Wan chopped him up into pieces. Yeah, Anakin was my favorite character.
Yeah.
And that's actually my favorite Star Wars movie was what? Episode 3.
Yeah.
How many is it?
Six. Oh, 7 now.
Damn. You only saw like 2?
My favorite one is the first one.
You only saw 2.
The very, very first one in Episode 3, that is the best one.
Too sweet, man.
Looks like get them bitches
with all Spaceballs.
Oh, Spaceballs is even better.
Spaceballs.
Remember they was out there in the desert?
The comedy.
They was like, comb the desert. They was out there in the desert with the combs. And then they got to the black dudes they had to pick. They asked the white dude, you find anything? No, sir, nothing. They asked the black dude, you find anything? He's like, man, we ain't found shit. That's your boy, Mel Brooks.
Hell no.
Hey, Spaceballs is classic.
Yeah. I let me go back in this. Unto the pure, all things are pure. But unto them that are defiled and unbelieving, is nothing pure.
It's nothing pure. It's like anything that we say to a demon, they're going to have a problem with everything we say. You know, like, they'll find something wrong with something we're saying.
Well,
it ain't nothing pure to two-thirds.
But even their mind and conscience is defiled.
Their mind and conscience is defiled. Like, people, they look at us, we'll say, we don't celebrate Christmas, and they looking down on us, like, ain't you going to buy your kids nothing? Like,
Scrooge.
Yeah, they call you, yeah, you're Scrooge.
You're, Scrooge is the good guy.
You're ruining Christmas.
You're
ruining Christmas.
Yeah,
you're ruining Christmas.
Goddamn Grinch.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, they'll call you a Scrooge, call you a Grinch. Yeah. You know, say, bah, humbug. And when all these different characters were created for the sole purpose of that. You know what I'm saying? It's all propaganda. It's to put people under a magic spell. There's a reason why all the Christmas carols were written by Jews, so-called Jews. We went into that last week, or 2 weeks ago. All your favorite Christmas carols were all written by so-called Jews, people who don't even celebrate Christmas. It's all part of the propaganda and part of the deception to keep you fools asleep, man.
It's fucking amazing. That's fucking amazing.
It's fucking amazing. I'll go ahead with that.
They profess that they know the Most High.
They profess. Oh, yeah, they celebrate. I know the God. That's why I celebrate Christmas, because I love Jesus. It's Jesus, baby Jesus Day.
Y'all got to bring Christ back into Christmas.
Yeah, we got to put Christ back into Christmas.
Christ.
What do you mean?
Christ, huh?
Christ, you mean Mithras? Oh, you mean
Amun-Ra?
Victus?
Christa? Damn God? It's like.
Christ simply means to anoint.
Wouldn't it like fucking like. Every god burned on December 25th.
Well,
like
it's the day of the sun. Gods. We done went over that 1,000 times. You know, December 20th.
Solstice.
Yeah, probably the solstice starts with the solstice. December 24th is the shortest day of the year. It is going to be dark as fuck. And you know, the sun goes down like 5 o'clock. But on Christmas, on December 25th, the day started to get longer again. So they say the sun has risen. That's why the ancient Romans. Starting in about the 2nd century, or was it 1st, 2nd century, they started worshiping Sol Invictus heavy, you know what I'm saying? That was like their top god. And then, you know, they celebrated Christmas. And they've been celebrating Saturnalia during the same time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That was always a pagan holiday.
What's
was
up,
Christmas.
Man? What's up, man?
What's happening?
King?
Hey, yeah, yeah.
How you doing,
Faraz's boy, ain't he?
Oh, what you
doing out here, though?
I'm trying to hear y'all.
Oh, you came out for us?
Huh?
You came out for us?
Oh, okay, I was passing by and seeing y'all. I was like, hallelujah.
Yeah, out here every week, man, doing the work like we're supposed to.
Hallelujah, man. You know? I just came back from Oaxaca, man. We down there teaching the brothers in Oaxaca, Puerto Escondido, Pico Tepa, Pahi. We teaching the brothers Zebulon and Issachar, the state of children of Israel, man. So, you know what I'm saying? Spirit moving, man. Hallelujah. I'm King, how you doing? Shut him up, man.
Time of awakening. The time of awakening.
Are you on the line? Like, what's up?
Man. Yeah, where'd that come from? Where'd that come from? Where'd that come from?
I don't know. It's just a salute.
That's what brothers do. It's just a thing that we Israelites, man. We cool.
Especially Judah.
Well, usually
we're
they
social
the
people, man. We're social people, man.
Yeah.
It's just what we do, you know?
Well, yeah, man.
He did say we are special people. We are peculiar people.
A peculiar.
You know? That's all, you know? But anyway, what I was saying, man, the end season, now the season. We out here every week, man.
Yeah, we usually
know.
Going
we don't
on
give a
Christmas.
Damn if we get 20 below zero. The Lord commanded us to get our asses out here and do this work, you know? It's a pleasure to us anyway.
Hallelujah.
You know?
God,
it's a pleasure. We look forward to it.
That's why I see y'all say, hallelujah, y'all, the brothers out on the highways and byways. And it's cold, man.
And we be all week long, man. We be miserable as hell, don't we? Miserable as hell, man, dealing with this world, man. We've been attacked.
When we teach is the only really joy we get.
It's the only
right.
You know what I'm saying? It's the only time I feel safe. It's the only time I feel safe. It's out here.
Right.
You know, pushing the spirit out.
When you out there in the world, man, it's just miserable.
Damn right. What was that? I'm gonna get back into this. They profess that they know the Most High, but in works, they deny Him.
Oh yeah, that's why we was going to that Christmas deal. You know, it's Jesus Day. You know, this is, they, like we used to say, they talking about they gonna put Christ back in
put
Christ
back into Christmas. But,
no.
He's never in prison.
It has madness, right?
Right. Yeah, I mean, the scriptures mention on, what's it, Molech? Moloch. How's it spelled? M-O-L.
It really comes from the Hebrew word king, Malak.
Right.
It's the same exact word.
And that's what these fools is offering their children to when they sit that, their little monsters in that devil's lap.
God.
That's why they're not red, you know?
Yeah, any other time you would sit your child on the stranger's lap and ask for presents, that would be considered pedophilia.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Sacrifice. That's offering. That's an offering. Offering.
That is an offering.
You're offering your children.
You know, that's a good, because you know Santa Claus wears that little hat with the bowl on top. If you look up pictures of Baal on the internet, he wears the same hat. You get that, you know?
Yeah, man, that's evil, man.
Yeah. Right. It's all by design, you know?
Yeah, definitely, man. I'm just glad to see your brother's
office. We was going to another thing, too. Did you know the older Christmas... Look up on Wikipedia if anybody can, or no. Not Wikipedia, Google it. Christmas carols written by Jews. You know, them fake Jews?
Mm-hmm.
Almost all the popular Christmas carols, Christmas songs, Jingle Bells, White Christmas... was all written by the so-called Jews, by Esau.
Amalek.
And they don't even celebrate Christmas.
Amalek, right.
Yeah, by Amalek, yeah.
Goddamn devils.
The joint don't be messing up out here in this cold.
You know what, when it gets colder, it will.
Yeah, mine has messed up, man.
It has.
It's just a record.
Screen cracker.
Yeah. My pictures, and I always got a black spot on it. I left out in the car, I was like,
watch out.
Yeah, I remember last year, my phone, my tablet was like, just pushing it, it's just...
In the freeze too.
Yeah.
Did you bookmark that one page?
Probably Mercury, yo.
Which one?
Shit.
Songs?
Yeah.
No, I never did. And I meant to go up here, as long as we go into it, the very same night. Yeah. You know, spirit always takes us somewhere else, you know how it is,
man. You know, we're talking about the Fifth Summit in California. You heard about the Fifth Summit?
California. When?
All the different camps coming together.
Yeah, but
going up for
women. Where?
California and Compton this year. I mean, January.
All the camps.
Yeah.
Well, they going off then.
Yeah, we don't go by camps. We say we Israel in Ohio.
Right.
And we building on one accord, just having that brotherly love. With
so let me ask you a question. Let me ask you a question, real quick question. You know, you met those before? Yeah. Remember? Okay, so you know Yahweh Shai, right? Did he come together with the Pharisees? Or did he always rebuke the Pharisees?
Because,
like, think about it.
The Lord said, do I come to bring peace? Nay, rather division.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, he said, gather yourselves together.
Right.
O nation I desire.
Hey, let's just stick one on topic, though, right now.
Which one
are
you
going?
I'll see
y'all
later.
The Jews
are Christmas songs. Just the first one.
Yeah, might as well. Where you? Gotta hop on a bus?
Yeah.
You sure, man? I can take you home, man. I don't care. I can take you home. I ain't trying to go home. I'm done. For real. You know how it is, man.
Hell yeah.
I was hoping to mention the song.
You got a
child, right?
Child born. Baby born.
Oh, yeah, I got two
children.
Roasting on the campfire.
You just have
mission
one?
Oh, my wife.
Hey, get this on camera.
Huh?
Hey, these are all the Christmas carols written by Amalek. Read them off.
Okay, 25 most popular songs, holiday songs, as determined by radio airplay and compiled by the American Society of Composers and Publishers. Each song is followed by the writer performer version received the most current written play. But these are songs, up here it says, the Jews who wrote Christmas songs.
Oh, the Jews who wrote Christmas songs.
The Jews who wrote Christmas songs. Yeah, Winter Wonderland.
Winter Wonderland. No, that's a famous.
The Christmas song, Chestnut Roasting on an Open Fire.
Oh, you know that,
that's popular.
Because you know, music is pretty much a form of magic. It alters someone's consciousness. It alters your perception of reality through that music, a certain melody, it puts a vibration on you.
Yep,
that's what that Christmas music put people in a spell. You know?
I need a cup of coffee or anything.
I'm cool.
It's the frequencies, the energy that's being put out. Yeah. The demonic frequency.
Vibration. That's what it is.
The vibration. Have yourself a merry little Christmas.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Right, straight from Esau.
Right.
Keep going.
Sleigh ride. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Oh, wow.
That's the Jackson song was popular with the fact that
Satan's Claus is coming to town.
Let it snow.
Wow, that's a real famous one,
yeah.
Too, boy.
White Christmas.
White, you know, with Bing Crosby.
Jingle Bell Rock.
All the top songs they got on, they got stations, that's all they play this time of year.
Yeah, that's why I can't even listen to the radio right now. Like,
it's hard to even go in the stores.
I'll listen to talk radio.
Shit.
That music gets stuck in my ear, your head, you know?
Yeah, the vibration.
You be trying to sleep, right. And it be like God. Blasting in your head and brain, man.
That's what it's created to
and
do.
I got to turn something else on.
Yeah.
Just to
soothe that mind.
To make you want to buy. That's why they play in the malls. Everywhere you go, it makes you want to get that spirit of buying and consumerism, man.
Yeah.
It's a form of magic.
It's
sorcery.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
Rudolph.
Little Drummer Boy. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the worst time of the year.
It's the coldest, the
darkest. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Ain't
rocking
no wonderful.
Rocking around the Christmas tree.
Christmas tree, that goes back to the groves. You know, in the Bible, y'all be studying the Hebrew, right? When you see that word grove in the English, you look it up in Hebrew, it says Asherah. And Asherah was the Canaanite queen of heaven. She was Baal's consort, who was Baal's wife. Mm. And she was represented by a tree.
Mm. Silver bells.
Silver bells.
The custom of the heathen, man.
Yeah, they go back to, yeah, right, Jeremiah 10.
I'll be home for Christmas. Feliz Navidad.
Feliz Navidad. They even wrote this Spanish song.
Wow, so it's a card to hear it, means every line can sing it.
So Amalek, he's really the only true, I want to use the word, global people on the planet. They post up, they control the whole planet. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, definitely.
They posted up in every country on this earth, manipulating people. You know what I'm saying?
They was in Mexico. I met this Jewish woman in Mexico. I was like, she was curious, like, so what are y'all? Why do y'all got these garments on? Why are y'all here? Interesting, while we was here, we was like, yo, you Amalek. Yo,
she's speaking English?
Yeah, she was speaking English. She's like, oh, thank you for English, but she speaks Spanish as well.
But they're all multilingual.
Yeah.
Multi.
And she was in the army, the Israel army.
Well, if they're from Israel, they have to serve, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I didn't know that.
Yeah, you know, they call,
there's a lot of us over there that's in the army.
From they had to try to get citizenship, they had to join the army.
Yeah, they're crazy as hell.
I know, right?
And that place got so many missiles, 22 at night.
Yeah, they was gonna be destroyed.
Funny thing about it, the ones of us that's over there, the land they living on is where they got radioactive waste buried.
Oh, wow.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, well,
they gave them the worst of the land over there.
I heard they was buying some kind of plant too, something.
We ain't even supposed to be over there, man. That's Luke 21:24, right? It should be trotted down by the Gentile until that time be fulfilled.
Let them do their deal. They'll find out what happens.
Right. They say it's a remnant that's supposed to be over there, though, right? They be saying a remnant.
Yeah, a remnant gonna get delivered out there.
Everybody got their own crazy-ass interpretation, and, you know. And, like the scriptures say, the blind lead the blinded, both of them fall in the pit.
That's right. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. A holly jolly Christmas. Frosty the Snowman.
What the hell is Frosty? Well, I've never researched that. I bet there's some kind of demonic symbolism behind Frosty. I gotta remind myself to research.
I mean, this devil loves being perverted to shit. Like the wreath around Christmas tree, that's sperm. That's the sperm of, I can't even think of the name.
The balls
you put on the tree.
You know where the word galaxy comes from? The Greek word milk. That's where you get the word lactose. The word lactose comes from a Greek word from milk. That's where you get galaxy, like lactose. Because they said the whole cosmos was created by the breast milk of the Queen of Heaven.
Oh, She wanted some attention. That was my wife.
You ever heard of that? Okay. Wow. Have you heard that before, though? They said the whole cosmos was created by the breast milk of the Queen of Heaven. That's why they call it the galaxy. It's named after milk.
Nah, I never knew that, though.
I gotta look that up. That's crazy. Mm-hmm.
There you go. Bring it out information.
If I look at the Greek.
Yeah, Greek. Look it up. Yeah, just do a word search on etymology of galaxy.
Oh, here's some adultery right here in one of the songs. Oh, I saw mommy kissing Santa Claus.
They love that song. And then they got the mistletoe. You know, you stand under the mistletoe, you gotta give someone a kiss.
Man,
I'm pretty sure that come out of Rome, and that's Roman.
The mistletoe is made from holly. Right? Holly is a. Each plant has its own astrological sign. And each plant, well, according to. You ever get to the farmer's almanac and stuff like that? Each plant is so called ruled by a different sign. And the holly plant, that's where you got Hollywood. A magician's wand's made from Hollywood. Okay. And it's under the sign of Saturnalia. It goes back to Saturnalia, you know what I'm saying?
Car. Yeah, that wand, that dumbass motherfucker in the movies, wave around.
That's why they got Hollywood, because Hollywood is the magic.
What's that movie with the little kid, the white boy?
The Home Alone?
The magic movie. Because I never watched none of them. Yeah. I can't remember the name of them.
Oh,
witchcraft movies, man.
Harry Potter.
He carries it.
Harry Potter.
That gets little children interested in.
Something on his head.
It gets children interested in magic.
Man,
you
know? I got a 3-year-old sister, and all of them shows on Nickelodeon, especially Disney Channel, every show is about magic.
Every show.
That's him.
Every show.
That's him.
What's up?
That's Josh all out here.
Who's
that? Is that Yasha Allah him?
Who that?
Is that Israel or him?
Burke? I don't know, man.
I'm trying to figure it out.
You got lost a little bit.
You know, but it's lost. Like, hold on, who are you talking about him? Like, him? Yeah. I ain't want to put no fingers at him, like.
Bro, we point fingers at everybody.
Nah, man, we judge people. We cool with people. You know what I'm saying? We cool with people, man. We used to be crazy, but if some people come out, we gonna talk to them. We just ain't gonna just.
Some of us in those. Here we go. Here comes Santa Claus right down Santa Claus Lane. Carol of Bells.
What the fuck is that? Santa Claus Lane. What is that?
Hey, I don't know.
That's crazy. There's demonic shit behind it. I'm sure. What's Santa Claus? As demonic as it gets right there.
Yes, sir.
Leaving cookies out for Santa Claus. That goes back to the cookies for Queen of Heaven. You know, back at Israel leave to bake cakes for the Queen of Heaven.
You know what I'm saying?
That goes hand in hand with that tree, with the tree worship. That's why you always read through the Book of Chronicles of Kings. They tell you, well, this king was a righteous king. He cut the groves down. You know, they go into over and over, man. Israel is constantly worshiping the devil.
Yeah, he's other gods, man.
That's why Santa Claus is red. The devil's red.
And we had so many idols down there in Mexico, man. They got so many statues, like little white Mary, Virgin Mary statues that's like.
Well, that's the Mary Guadalupe.
Huh?
They said that was the image that came from heaven.
Huh,
you know?
They worship that woman, man. That's crazy, man.
Huge. But that's what the image was. Yeah, they came from it. They also worship, they got a patron saint named Jesus Malverde. You seen that one? It's the Bandito saint. Then they got the Santa de Muerte, the angel of death they worship.
Oh, yeah.
They burn incense to it. Go out to the West Side Flea Market. You been out there? Out on Broad Street, up by 270 Broad.
Where the old mall used to be at?
Yeah, right across the street from the mall.
Used to be a bowling alley. Okay, come on.
That's the land of Issachar. You go up, they run that whole mall pretty much. Okay.
Was there anyone there yesterday?
Not the mall, the flea market. But you go in there, nothing but idols.
Everything was open there.
They sell the idols.
Every booth was open.
They're everywhere. You can buy Mary hats, Mary boots, Mary belt buckles. You know what I'm saying?
I noticed it was like, three tribes
there,
man.
Stand outside the flea market teacher, like, the people going in, like.
I noticed like three tribes here.
Oh, yeah?
They gonna let you be out here. We made a video in there. They kicked us out.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Squirrels running.
They acted. They like. We got the.
He's like, delete the video.
I was like, I'm not deleting the video, dude.
You know what I'm saying? That was funny.
That was a good. That was a good time. Some of the dudes over there is cool though. They talk to us.
I need to heat my hands now.
Man, cause it's a few hours.
I can't return the page. Right.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. The whole neck.
We're supposed to be almost 60. It's not that bad this year though. Last year was way worse.
They're predicting an easy win. They're predicting one.
After the last two of them.
Almanac said it was supposed to be a terrible
win. Yeah, they're saying an easy win.
Farmers of Almanac is goddamn witchcraft.
They're saying that El Nino is coming through.
The farmer's over there. This is all his own.
This woman waiting on me, man.
Oh, that's cool, man.
You're going to end up in divorce.
I got the boys up in that car, too, though.
Right,
so
right,
All right, then.
Hey, let me ask you a question, man. How many of y'all go down to Mexico?
How many of us there?
Don't go down there. A lot of brothers.
No, we only went two.
Oh, just you? Oh, okay.
Two brothers, man. Next time, we hope to bring more brothers, man.
Right.
We're going down to Brazil too, though. We got invited to Nicaragua, Colombia, all these places.
How y'all gonna pay for that?
Dangerous,
huh? How y'all gonna pay for that?
Brothers got, you know what I'm saying, funds, businesses, man. You know, our money doubles in Mexico, so, you know, income tax season coming up.
I don't know.
So a dollar is like 16 pesos,
right.
So it's easy to live down there. So yeah, you go down there, you know what I'm saying? And we don't, you know what I'm saying, we ain't thinking about that.
Yeah, passports and everything.
Y'all got passports, huh?
You got an RFID in there.
Yeah, I know. Tracking that. Hey, you gotta move though, man. It's like everybody up here teaching the people.
You gonna get the chip when it comes?
Huh?
You gonna get it when it comes?
Come on, gang there, right? Ain't gonna get no chip.
You know, a lot of people say they ain't gonna get it, but gonna get it.
Man.
You know, cause they got too many favors of the world. They ain't trying to give up them favors. You know
right,
that.
Right.
Like, for example, you imagine LeBron James if he.
He already got
it. Well, you're right. But imagine if he didn't, though, in the crash, which is coming, the crash. And he going, come on, man.
You know, I don't have an ID right now. Right, I'm catching all kind of hell because of.
Right. So he made you.
No, so I got pulled up. I got pulled over, you know what I'm saying? Motherfucker, impound my shit, get the bond, got to go to court. I can't even, if I want to get a little something to drink, I go to the store, they ID you. I can't even get nothing to drink. So I just gotta walk around sober and pissed off. Right. I'm like a teenager asking someone to buy me.
Right. They stood outside the store like I was.
Yeah. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like I gotta go to the hood spots to get it.
Right.
You know what I mean?
But what Paul say in Romans, is it 8:38? He said, I'm persuaded that none of these things can keep us from the love of God. So man, with me, you know what I'm saying? Brother, man, I gave up for a year now. I've been living. I'm renting out a room in my mother's crib. I used to work at OSU, man. They try to have me work on the Kadash. I said, yo, I'm not working on the Holy Day. Yeah. I'm not working on the Shabbat. I quit my job. Like,
well, you don't use crutches, man. You ain't got no choice, though.
Exactly. So, now at the end of the day, man, we're supposed to obey the Most High overall.
But the Most High said, man, the money is a defense. You're going to need it.
He said, we'd rather be poor man to be poor and fear God
than
him be rich.
The Lord worked on the Sabbath.
Yeah, but he also said,
the Lord worked on the Sabbath, and then they wanted to arrest him for it.
Which, you said,
the Sabbath was made for man, but the man was not made for Sabbath.
He did good works, though.
But we live in Satan's kingdom.
Yeah, of course. How you think we come out here to camp?
When is the Sabbath? When is the Sabbath?
From Friday's sunset to.
That's not true.
That's not in the Bible.
That's not true.
It says from evening to morning was the day.
Yeah, but
it's not on Saturn's day.
Where did it come?
Saturn's day. Yeah, we know the terminology of the week days.
According to the Bible, the Sabbath is according to the cycles of the moon.
Huh. Oh, so you go by the.
Cause let me ask you a question.
The moon.
Cause like, I'm sorry, it came too fast.
We had this discussion for hours.
Yeah. And I, you know,
being like,
hold up, let me get this out.
Don't judge people on Sabbaths,
right.
holy days. So,
but you know, let me get this out real quick.
Deal, you know,
but
what
you know how
all the laws, that's good.
Nobody is keeping
right,
all the laws.
It's not possible.
You say by our faith, man.
But look, you know how like the moon goes by the month, right?
I don't know.
This is new shit right here. Now look, if the new moon makes the first day of the month. What's 6 days later?
But the days was being counted before the
you
movie.
You see what I'm saying? Oh. You hear what I said?
In the scripture, they tell you that the devil, he changed all the times, the ordinances, and everything. The calendar. Right now, we're under a Gregorian calendar, which was not instituted until Pope Gregory. Before that, they followed the Julian calendar, which was instituted under Caesar. Under Caesar.
You get it?
So, any calendar you go by is wrong. You don't even know what month it really is. Look how off the seasons are.
Yeah, we don't know what year it is.
Nobody's keeping the Passover on the right day. You pray to the Lord that you hope.
Spring, though. We know when the spring come in. And
When did the spring rain came in this year in June?
Yeah, it came in.
It sure did.
Calendar's off, bro.
We know this.
Everything's
But still, I'm going to get to the point where Friday sundown to Saturday sundown.
Yeah.
You know, that's what we're trying to get at.
Yeah.
You know? But then again, there are some people doing it that could be sincere. There are some that's doing it.
But
you can't teach that if Friday's not in the Bible, Saturday's not in the Bible.
Because Friday comes from Freya.
First day, third day.
Friday's named after Freya.
But it said new moon. Every new moon don't come every Friday sundown to Saturday sundown.
It changes.
It's not exactly 24 hours in a day.
There's not exactly 30 days in a month.
Right.
It's like 20.
I'm not over here saying, I ain't trying to find a discourse or anything between us, brother. I'm trying to build.
No doubt.
For me, it's like, you know what I'm saying? If we have
to come out here and there has to be discourse. Has to be.
And that's going
to
be, I think that's going to be settled. And everything is going to be in the wilderness.
First Corinthians, let me get scripture. Wilderness.
We ain't going.
Ain't no wilderness.
Ain't no more wilderness, bro.
Ain't no wilderness?
Ain't no more wilderness. Ain't no more
wilderness.
When we come back down out of those chariots, we're going to be in the wilderness then.
You know? So we're not headed to the wilderness?
After we come down out the chariots, after all the destruction takes place, we will be in the wilderness then. But
that's where we're going to make the new covenant with us.
Right.
In Ezekiel 20 and 33.
Let me get a scripture real quick.
But think about it, though. You know what I'm saying? Can you answer that, though?
Probably.
If the new moon was, because you believe that, right? The new moon is the first day, right?
Huh.
First day in the month,
because the days of the month.
Yeah, so every 7 days. Yeah, so every 7 days, so 6 days later, gotta be the Sabbath, right? So it's 6 days later, gotta be the Sabbath. It gotta be the seventh day, right?
Check this out.
So it's not always Friday and Saturday.
Let me read this real quick. 1 Corinthians 1:10. Now I beseech you, brethren, by the name of our Lord Yahweh Shai, that ye all speak the same thing, and that there be no divisions among you.
There you go.
But that you be perfectly joined together in the same mind and the same judgment.
We can't be joined together with people that's pushing out that divergent verse. You know? You can't join together with people that's pushing them.
Hades. Right.
You know?
Hades.
Right.
You can join with, look, you believe in Yahweh Shai, right?
Yeah.
I believe in Yahweh Shai.
But there are people that's in the Bible that believe in Yahweh Shai, like the scripture says, Lord, Lord, the ones that called on the name.
What's
Lord,
that one
Lord?
He said, the one he hated in Revelation? He was teaching some bullshit.
Hold on, let me get
in Revelation, the dude, he said he hates him.
Wait a minute, what's that?
Revelation, the first chapter.
Right.
You keep the commandments,
no, it's
right?
Revelation 2, actually.
Right?
Yeah.
In Revelation 2.
So that's things we should be building.
But the Pharisees believe in keeping the commandments, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, see? The Pharisees, they
believe in Yahweh Shai,
though. Right, but they believe in the commandments, though, right?
They believe in Yahweh Shai, so that's why we find discourse. We can't walk together.
Hey, Marcion was teaching Yahweh Shai. And
Marcion.
You know Marcion? He's the one that said the Paul. Well, he pretty much said that, just go look up Marcion. He said Paul was the only one that got it right. And then he broke down Paul's scriptures wrong.
And what Paul say? Paul said, who is Apollo? Who's Paul?
Yeah, but they both is in the truth. Though.
That's 1 Corinthians 3.
That's like saying, who is him and who is him? Like, you might, right. Like, some brother might learn from him, but some brother might learn from him.
Like, I'm genuinely Johanna brought me the truth. One brother be like, oh, this brother brought
like
me the truth.
Like, Marcion, what Marcion taught was that the God of the Old Testament was the devil, is what he taught.
And plus, what's that one scripture that says, don't commune with them, but rebuke them?
It was a big heresy.
Yeah, that's bad right there.
You know, I mean, you always had different,
and plus,
I mean, you got people who believe in the Trinity. You got people, you can't kick it with people like that. Or teach certain things. You know?
We all can be corrected, though, bro.
Well, of course. What I'm saying, though, is you got to receive correction to be corrected.
The Lord.
I'm open to receive. If I'm wrong on something, and I know I'm wrong, I'm admit I'm wrong.
Right.
that's how I got this truth to begin with.
Right.
You know, that was, you know, I was a pretty much, I was a heathen.
Right.
We was all heathens at one time.
Well, pride comes contention, so you got to drop that pride. I mean, that's how you get to understand it, man. We got to fear the Most High and depart from evil.
And the Lord said, if your eye offends you, cut it off. Or because if you read Corinthians, he explained about different parts of the body, right? About how that's, you all one body. He said, like, for instance, he's the leg, he's the eyeball.
Right, different parts of the body.
You know what I'm saying? And that, because, and when the Lord said, if your hand offends you, cut it off. So if he's talking about,
that's beautiful.
If he's talking about the Lord's coming back in 2016, and he's talking about he's coming back in 2025. You got, you know, whoever got the truth, whoever is lying or whatever, he got to cut them off. I'm just making a point. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Revelation,
you know what I'm saying?
In 15, the Lord says, so yes, also them that hold the doctrine of Nicolaitanus, which I hate. And this was a letter to the churches.
Yeah, I'm
who that?
And you know what I'm saying? This is a letter that was written to the seven churches, right? And the Lord said there was certain people teaching doctrines that he hated. You know what I'm saying?
That's right. That's
and, I mean,
right.
They come, and they coming in the name of Yahweh Shai.
Right. And nobody has 100% truth.
Oh, we got 100% truth.
100% truth if you teach them out of the scripture and so far as keeping the command, how you get eternal life. If it's not preventing nobody from getting eternal life, I'm not going to debate with it. I'm not going to go against you. You're saying that's let the Most High sort that out.
I know you're saying because, like the writings of Paul said, is don't hold, you know, certain people hold the Sabbath on different days, and they got different interpretations of when the holy days are.
Right, right.
He said, where is that? Is that in Romans? What is that?
I'm trying to find yourself in there. Trying to decide
hey guys.
To. I could
find him.
Hey guys.
You know that guy?
No.
What was he so happy about?
I don't know. He's happy about something. He's happy about something.
That guy gave me his creeps.
Hey guys.
So Esau is happy though. Man. He got all the reasons to be happy. Until,
he was probably a.
What the fuck?
He was probably a Jesus freak.
Yeah.
It's cold.
Okay, this is Philippians 1:27. Only let your conversations be as it becometh the gospel of the anointing, that whether I come and see you or else be absent, I may hear of your affairs, that ye stand in one spirit, with one mind, striving together for the faith of the gospel.
Leavens the whole lump. One little thing that's off in there. If you let a brother slip on one thing, like they say, you give them an inch, they take a mile. You know
right,
what I'm
right,
saying?
Right, you got
right. Give it. I mean,
like
things can get out of hand. But brother, you let brother slide on one thing. Next thing you know, he's teaching about the angels live on other planets. The Anunnaki's coming back. Ancient aliens.
Yeah, we can grow a weed house.
We smoking weed. We see, you know what I'm saying? All kind of bugged out.
Yeah, I got a weed house in my garage.
We don't see. We see it. You know what I mean?
You know what I'm saying?
If you don't stamp it out, it gets out of hand.
That's right. That's right.
It go. You don't want to go down that road.
Mm-hmm.
We done heard some people say something.
I mean, like you married, man. You ain't supposed to be taking your wife to no synagogue.
No.
Around other men.
No.
You know what I mean? That's how that breeds adultery.
That's
so another man, that can also breed division between you and your wife.
You mean to learn?
Yeah, to learn. She wants to learn from you at home.
At home.
And that's it.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying?
Because
another one, imagine a man teaching you. And your wife looking at you, a man looking at you taking orders from another man. She's gonna start looking down on you eventually, man.
She will. She will. Who was it the last time?
You know, you taking orders from another man. You know what I mean? Learning from another man, especially if that man got a little leaving up in that knowledge. You know what I'm saying?
And
she's
gonna
eventually. She's gonna. That's what really throws her off.
Yep.
If that man is.
If he gets you on something, makes you look stupid.
Man, you know. Because that's what they do. They look for that opportunity to cause division.
That's why when the Lord had the Last Supper, what meal was that they were eating? The Passover meal, right? The Last Supper. How many women attended that one?
Where was Mary at?
They got Mary in the picture.
Yeah.
They got her in the picture twice.
Yeah. Joseph and Mary both their parents going to when they was when they lost your Howard shot.
With that feast thing.
Yeah, but that's his parents. He cursed his mom out.
Huh?
He cursed his mom out.
Mom and dad.
His mom told him to turn water into wine. He's like, woman, what am I going to do with you? You know what I'm saying?
It ain't my time.
He didn't have his mom up in the Last Supper with him.
Right.
That was,
they went to the Passover, though. We know that.
But that was before the Lord came. When the Lord had his deal, his parents weren't in the truth. You know what I'm saying?
He said his parents weren't in the truth.
They thought they knew.
No, he was a righteous man. What I'm saying is they was not doing what the... That was before the Lord had his ministry. Okay, so they was still following, you know what I'm saying, what they was raised to do.
Oh, the
when the Lord came in, he told everybody, this is what's going down. Mm-hmm. And then when he had the Last Supper, it was just him and his brothers. And that was it. There was no woman. Mary Magdalene went up in there.
Mm-hmm.
If his mom was right, super Israelite woman, how come she wasn't there?
Right.
She should have been right there.
Yeah, you already know.
The guy's house where they had the Passover, he wasn't even upstairs. He was downstairs. He wasn't even invited.
Get Matthew 12. They said, your mother sits here desiring to speak with thee.
This about to die.
Yeah, yeah.
He said, my mother, my father, my brother, are those who do the will of the Father.
Here you go.
You know what I'm saying? He didn't say, come here. Mom, great Israelite queen. He didn't say that.
Right.
Well, I'm not speaking against Mary, because you know, the scriptures say she was a good woman, you know what I mean? The point is though, is that he was concerned about the elect men, and that was it. That's what the Lord cares about.
Hold on, I'm gonna try to get this up.
Was you looking at Matthew 12?
No, just other one.
Okay. Damn. People say we're misogynists and you know.
Yeah.
Man, we ain't got time to deal with women, man. To us, women are... what you gonna do with them? You can't teach them.
You still can't teach a woman?
Shit.
Oh, man. Where? Some of these women, they might be sincere. You know, we'll teach them. Teach them a little something. We'll throw a dog a bone.
You said Corinthians, though. I'm trying to think.
Maybe you can't teach most men, let alone women. Even Solomon said in the book of Ecclesiastes, what he said, Ecclesiastes, the 7th chapter, I have 1,000 men I searched and only found one righteous man. But out of those 1,000, not one woman have I found.
Ecclesiastes.
You know what I'm saying? You know, we ain't saying women are evil or nothing like that, but
their ways, huh?
Very, like the Proverbs says, who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. Very, very hard to find. If you can find a good woman that you like, you want to dwell with her, that's cool. But she ain't going to be out doing the work. You know what I mean?
Right, you can't take the woman wherever
it ain't going to happen.
Shit.
For the most part,
to teach other women, though.
Of course. That's the order. That's the proper order. That's the order right there.
Yeah, but if I was y'all, I'd keep my wife out of that building, though.
Yeah.
That's your, I'm telling you.
But then you
get you're going to notice. Because I'm telling you, man, the closer we get to the end, the vision is going to kick hold. And it's already mad division going on.
Because like
the vision is going to get worse
like
and worse.
Like we said earlier, a lot of these women.
But we ain't supposed to be no unity nowhere, though. But the truth. This is the only unity that's going to take place.
Yeah.
Brothers coming into the truth.
Goddamn elect.
Man, that's to gather ourselves.
Yeah, the elect.
Yeah, right.
The elect.
Right. But that's 2/3 ain't gathering themselves. You know?
Yeah, the elect. The elect. The elect.
The elect. The elect, though.
The elect.
You're talking about the elect, though.
We're only concerned with the elect.
That's right. That's right.
That's walking up to the knowledge and know who they are.
Right.
And teaching this word.
Not even all of them.
So you think a brother wake up to the knowledge that he learned he an Israelite? You think that's it?
No.
There's much more to it than that.
We already know that.
Much more to it.
Because we don't live in fantasy land. We don't live in fantasy land. So we know there ain't going to be no Israelite communities up there drinking Kool-Aid. There ain't going to be no Israelite. All this shit's going to be destroyed. This whole country is going to be turned to a pile of ass.
It's already
a pile of shit.
Like when the scripture says, come out and